Hello everyone, welcome to yet another exciting video from Chukwuka Obelagu vlog. Today, the cryptocurrency community is excited that our dear Donald Trump has recognized cryptocurrency and recognized Bitcoin. Okay? Now, most of you guys might not understand his tweet, and that is why I'm doing this video to clarify you guys about the tweet before this turns into a fraud meaning fear, uncertainty, and doubt. Okay, before everybody starts crying wolf, let me explain to you his tweet. You know one thing for sure, that Donald Trump is a nationalist. Okay, he's a patriot. So anything that has to do with the United States, he doesn't joke with it. And as long as he's seeking re-election, the US dollar and America will always become his number one priority in any tweet or in any statement he makes. So don't mistake that for being against Bitcoin or being against cryptocurrency. So as you can see, his tweet as of yesterday, July 11, 2019, 5:15. Now, let me be clear on this. I'm doing this video on the 12th. Today being on the 12th. Okay? So, probably this should be some few hours, okay, after this tweet was released. But let me just read what he said. He said, "I'm not a fan of Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies, which are not money," that's his opinion, "and whose value is highly volatile based on thin air." Okay? "Unregulated crypto assets can facilitate unlawful behavior like drug trade and other illegal activity." Then on the other tweets he made, he said, "Similarly, Facebook Libra's virtual currency will have little standing or dependability. If Facebook and other companies want to become a bank, they must seek a new banking charter and become subject to all banking regulations, just like other banks, both national and international. We have only one real currency in the US, and it is stronger than ever, both dependable and reliable. It's by far the most dominant currency anywhere in the world, and you always stay that way. It is called United States dollar." Yes, we know how strong the US dollar is. Yes, we know how dominant it is. But we know Donald Trump is up for re-election. And we know that some of the points he has made about his re-election has been how the stock market has been performing. Okay? And if people are moving their investment from stock market and the US dollar and securities to go and put into Bitcoin and go and buy Bitcoin futures and put into Bitcoin hedge funds, okay, what does that spell for the US dollar? So he is just protecting the interest, his interest number one, of being re-elected, and history and America's interest in terms of positive economic indicators. So that's what he's supposed to. Now, he's not against Facebook Libra. Okay, let me come to Facebook Libra. He's only saying that if Facebook Libra wants to operate the way they want to operate, then definitely they have to go and get a banking charter for national and international purpose. Meaning they have to be under regulation. Because if you look at Facebook Libra, for example, okay, Facebook Libra already has database. So what most banks are struggling to get, Facebook already has through WhatsApp, through Instagram, to Facebook, through Messenger. Okay, and the Libra, which is the coin, is already in the hands of the Libra Association, which Facebook only has 1% say in it. Though the Libra is not decentralized like most cryptocurrency, but they have plans of being decentralized in the future. Okay, but if you look at the Libra Association, you know that they are made up of organizations who are service providers who will definitely support the Libra ecosystem. At the same time, if you look at what is backing the Libra, you will find out that what is backing Libra is actually certain central bank instruments. They didn't specify which government central bank, but they say some central banks across the world, and some of the things that are backing Libra are bank deposit, which is what you know as fixed deposit, and bank securities such as bonds, treasury bills, you know, commodity, what's it called, commercial paper, those kind of things are short-term stuff, so short-term instruments that back the Libra. So when you look at that system, that looks like a banking service to you, because Libra Association is now the bank. They have the customers, which are Facebook customer base. They have merchants who already has a stake in the bank, and the funds from the initial sales of Libra, or whatever funds generated, is going to be backed. Was going to be put into securities and bank deposit. That's how a bank runs. Okay, banks take deposit from you. Okay, insure it, go and put it in CBN, in the central bank, in form of, you know, deposit, which will represent security deposit, and some of them will go into treasury bills and securities and bonds. So you find out that that's the way. So Facebook Libra is more like a looking like a bank. So that's why Donald Trump is saying that they should go and get banking charter so that they can be under regulation. And Facebook Libra didn't say they don't want to be regulated. They're not like Bitcoin or most cryptocurrencies out there that is talking about being unregulated. Okay. Facebook wants to be regulated. They want to do everything by the book. Okay? So, Congress has already been defeated, given the fact that Facebook already has 1%. So, the issue of trust and the privacy issue that Facebook had before is already out of the books. And then you're not talking about regulation, which Donald Trump already specified what they need to do. All they have to do is just go and get a banking charter. It's as simple as that. Okay? So you now have, if they get a banking charter, that means they're a bank using cryptocurrency to run their transaction. And so I hope this is clear. So most of you guys who are interested in Libra do not see this as a way to shy away from Libra. Libra is here to stay. Okay? And nothing is going to change that. Okay, and Donald Trump just gave Facebook and Libra Association the leeway for them to get accepted. Because one thing for sure you need to know is that the US is always after revenue. How can they make money out of this? So being under the regulation of the bank, paying taxes and the rest of them are ways the US government will allow Libra to run freely without too much scrutiny. So guys, I just want to do this analysis. I don't want to dwell too much on this, but I hope you guys understand my point. That's my opinion, okay? If you have a different opinion, okay, feel free to comment in the comment section. You can call me or chat me to ask me about Facebook Libra or to ask about Bitcoin or any other cryptocurrency you want to talk about. So I'll see you guys next time. So I'm Chokobelago. Take care. Bye for now.